Hey, what's going on, everyone? This is Jackadash here. Welcome back to Metroid Other M.
This elevator is bound for the main sector.
Last episode, we had fought Ridley. And also found out a good deal of what's going on around here.
This elevator is bound for Sector 2.
Now we're headed to as gathered from the intro. Brother. Okay, gotta put that on silence. Sorry, that was my phone. Forgot I had it in here. Yes. Yeah, but as gathered indicated from the intro, we're headed to Sector Zero, which is sort of like a Turian clone. Where we hope to find both the Metroids and MB, which is basically the, like a sort of Mother Ring clone of sorts. And also, it seemed that a leader was coming for Adam, and also came for the lady. Which is part of why we now have no... like, the authorization... mechanic of this game is basically over. Now, it's just basically Samus deciding at what point... should she activate certain abilities. Which, the first of which, that she activated on her own, was the screw attack and the space jump. Which makes easy work of creatures like the Kyrations, as you just saw. And also at the end of last episode, we, for the first time, got a confirmed kill of the Rhodosian creature, and from whom we got Seeker Missile. Anti-gravity to reckon with. Which is also like a rather cool like, something I had mentioned that I thought was pretty cool was how like, a use for the grapple beam that has not been repeated that was in this game. I don't know if it's been... I don't know if it's not been entirely repeated, but... it's like there's this one lava... boss. Lava monster boss. I think it's called the Vorash or something, but... part of how you fight it... and now this part is super gravity. So now I'm like, if I try jumping, I get just forced to the ground. And I can't speed boost. But it was like one of the, part of how you fought the Vorash or whatever is a specific use of the grapple beam that has not really been repeated as far as I know. And what that is you basically go fishing for it. And I just think that's something that's really cool and also kind of obvious. Or, like, of a potential use for it. I'm just kind of like, oh, yeah, why not? And I bring that up because it's kind of like another sort of obvious use of an upgrade that is, again, not really repeated, but is in this game. Which is the use of the gravity suit, or the gravity feature, rather. Like, not at any point is, like, the gravity suit, like, actually used for something that's gravity-related, exactly. Except in this game. And so it's kind of like, oh yeah, why not? And like, this is the only time in Metroid where there's like rooms and such that are like super affected by gravity. The only exception is when you fight the Nightmare in Metroid Fusion, and then because he has the ability to manipulate gravity. Whew. It really does a good job making you actually feel heavy, like feverishly heavy. Which, remember that I brought up the Nightmare when it comes to gravity related things. I wonder if that's like the generator for like anti-gravity and super gravity and stuff. A big round room. Who could it be? That's cool. They also like explain why he's got those tubes on the back. Because like, you know, that is what he looks like in Metroid Fusion. But, like, there are some aspects that you're like, that aren't really explained. But right there, they explain it. Oh, those tube things are, like, connected. Ah, whoops. Crummy. Really, since moved on to that. Oh. Shoot. He's manipulating gravity again. Which, when he does that, the only thing, like, you can only blast his generator. And missiles are not gonna do anything. Oh, what the? Well, I think missiles can actually hit his generator because, well, I mean, they're gonna be drawn to it anyway. But they're not gonna do anything to it. So you need the ice or the freezing aspect of your beam to disable it, because you're like, It's interesting, like, the fusion version of Nightmare and, oh, I'm not moving. Or I'm not making it. Headed for Federation HQ. But it's like the fusion version of the Nightmare and this game's version of the Nightmare are both just freaky and disturbing for their own reasons. It's like, I think the face behind the mask is more disturbing in Fusion, but the sounds the Nightmare makes in this game are a lot more disturbing. Either way, they're both just stupid freaky. The music for this part is pretty cool. Anticipation. Appear to be being watched and or followed. Well, and followed, rather.
A baby.
Can't let your guard down. This isn't the same one. Those freeze guns are no joke. Still a bit of a lame excuse to get Samus in her Zero suit for this part. I mean, yeah, I get it. It's like kind of like part of it is to emphasize her humanity and vulnerability for this part. But still,
Samus,
the
can you hear my voice?
It's a bit much.
I read you loud and clear, Adam.
You know what lies up ahead. The Metroids and the artificial intelligence that controls them. The fruit of the Galactic Federation's twisted project.
Yes. So why did you shoot me?
You can't destroy these Metroids.
What do you mean?
Sector Zero Metroids most likely can't be frozen.
What are you talking about?
There's a strong likelihood that the Metroid's mortal weakness, the vulnerability to cold, has been overcome through genetic manipulation. And if that's true, there's no way you can destroy them.
But that baby earlier, the infant Metroid, you were able to freeze it.
True. My guess is that it was because it was still in a larval stage. But who can say? One thing's for certain. They're definitely propagating Metroids. Developing bioweapons with an obvious and fatal flaw would be suicide. It's hard to imagine the military mass-producing defective weapons. Then again, none of this makes sense. Metroids are lethal. Their extinction was a wise decision. And now, since no one has the technology to defeat them, they cannot be allowed to exist.
Hang on, Adam. First, I need to know why you're credited as the creator of the Metroid Military Program Report.
I received the request to write the report from Galactic Federation headquarters. In that report, I outlined the potential dangers of such a program and explained categorically why it shouldn't be attempted. HQ listened, but a small group within the Federation co-opted my report for its own purposes.
Yeah, so most of the Federation is not on board with what's going on here.
Samus, you'll be fully recovered soon. I have several missions for you, His facility appears to be on an intercept course with Galactic Federation HQ. If what Madeline Bergman said is correct, there's a distinct possibility that this is the start of an attack by MB against the Federation. One way or another, some sort of attack is clearly imminent. You have to find a way to divert the ship off its intercept course. I've located a survivor in room MW, toward the rear of the Bioweapon Research Center. Whoever it is will be a key witness. Secure the survivor's safety, and defeat Ridley. He's as much of a threat as the Metroids. And one last word of warning. Madeline Bergman is no ally.
Certainly a lot of blue at this part.
Hold on, Adam. What are you planning to do with the Metroids
including
here in
Adam's
Sector
hair.
Zero?
Leave it to me. I'll deal with this place.
You have a plan for dealing with Metroids that can't be frozen?
Sector Zero has a self-destruct protocol. If the sector receives a significant amount of damage, the unit is programmed to detach and self-destruct. A powerful explosion will eliminate the Metroids and MB without leaving a trace.
Don't you dare, Adam. Let me go in. I'm the only one who has a shot against the Metroids. We have to take the chance. Please,
not in your
Adam.
Current state.
You have to trust me. You have to trust me. Just give me a chance.
Samus, I wish I could battle Ridley, but I can't. Unlike you, I'm no galactic savior. I'm merely human. But I can save you. You should be completely healed soon. There isn't much time. We both need to get started on our missions. I'm sorry for getting a little rough with you. Good luck, Samus. Objections. Right, lady?
Like, that's my girl.
Adam vanished. My best friend. The person who understood me best. The closest thing to a father I had. Thoughts swirled through my head. I couldn't come to grips with what had happened. Such a cruel way to say goodbye. I was the only one who witnessed Adam's last moment. And though it shook me, I was calmer than I usually am. I think Adam granted me that Eye of the Storm clarity, his final gift to me. There was no time for me to grieve his death, but there was time for me to say, Adam, thank you. Leave the rest to me.
I will acknowledge that there are a few problems with that scene. But I will also acknowledge that I did just shed a few tears. So, I'll just, not elaborate on either one of those. Oh boy. Aha. So the gravity feature allows things such as not only resisting gravity, but also generating gravity. Like that right there, which like I said, in either, I think it was this episode, yeah. it's like this is the first game and kind of only game to actually acknowledge the word gravity in the gravity suit. Now, another critique the Gaming Sense guy, as I was saying, the something the Cinema Sense or Gaming Sense fellow mentioned was, like, Adam's sacrifice there is pointless because of various other things later that happened in the game. And really, it's not, because the threat itself was imminent and immediate. And at the time, you don't actually know that MB isn't even in that location. And so, all the more reason why the threat needed to be eliminated then and there immediately. Oh, hello. How are you doing? Oop. Oh, brother, you're not dead, are you? Sound like a demonic version of a baby. Yeah, except this time, I've got the gravity feature, Buster. Oh, right. Yeah, I don't think I need to ask why you're called the Nightmare. Thing is a bit kind of reminds me of General Grievous in the sense that I'm just kind of like, it's like your very existence seems like misery. Ah, great. Now you put like a black hole in like a specific area. So you basically have to just aim it right so that it actually hits the generator. Now this second this second round versus the Nightmare in this game is significantly more like freaky or just disturbing because he's constantly making that horrifying noise. And also, it just kind of makes you feel bad that you're actually killing it or harming it. But at the same time, you just want it to die. Yeah, I think he's had enough. But it's just all through this fight, you're just kind of feeling, what even are you? It's like, why are you alive? And just die! So freaky. That may be the one enemy that I've actually like called freak. When I was like fighting it the first time, I'm just like, just die, you freak! I do kind of like this version of the gravity suit. Quote unquote suit, of course. But just having this purple aura instead of an actual suit. It's kind of cool. Pretty cool, actually. Makes you look really powerful. you guys are still stuck up there. Ow. Okay. I was just finding the map a little hard to read for some reason. Yeah, it's one of those examples of like how, in spite of all of its flaws, Other M is still just on its face, a pretty sad game. Like, has a pretty sad story. Call yourselves. I mean, I know how you spell it, but how do you pronounce it? Oh, right. This is the door I couldn't go through at first. Because it has a super missile barrier. Now I have the super missile. Wait a minute, I'm going the wrong way. Wait, no, I'm not. Thank you. gone just like that. He didn't even stand a chance. Forgot it actually activated something. I thought I already got all the expansions in this room. So yeah, the Kyration is gonna show up again. Nope. Which, now that I think about it, I wonder if they're called Volfons, like it's a mixture of wolf and fawn. Because that's kind of what they're, like a mixture of. Ah, right, the item I'm looking for is in this... room with the that's not all the items in here though, is it? Break these things. Ooh. By the way, yeah, it's one of those things you can't actually leave. That ride was significantly shorter compared to the first time. Well, that's because there were a bunch of enemies I was fighting. It's all the known expansions for now.
This elevator is bound for the main sector.
I don't remember how you're supposed to get up there, or if you're supposed to get up there. Oh. Oh, no. Excel chart. Yeah. That'll certainly come in handy. I remember for some reason that puzzle took way longer than it should have. Let's try this one more time. There is no like, secret that's like identified in here. Excuse me.
This elevator is bound for sector 3.
Okay. Not going to the objective just yet. Just considering there's a... Just want to make sure I am well prepared. Oh, hello there, Mr. Magdalite. this is the one. Yeah. Just see how resistant or lava resistant I am in comparison to when I to what I was when I was first in this room. Did the trick. Huh. Revealed an item, did it? Supposed to get up there. I don't remember. Oh, wait. Oh, neat. Yeah, see what I mean? I just, while I was shooting a super missile, I accidentally launched a, the seeker missile. Wait.
No, that's not it. Huh. Oh, I forget, I still get harmed by that. This must activate the little hatch. Yep. Just 31 more missile expansions to go. Okay. Oops. Huh? Where do you come from? Oh. Now that doesn't really make sense, but... whatever. Excuse me. Oh, I don't even have to hurt him a bit first. I can just screw attack him. Did it again. Oh, and by the way, allow me to demonstrate a very comical way to navigate in this game, which is scooting. How you accomplish that is instead of holding down the direction of the D-pad, instead you just continuously tap
continuously lightly tap the direction you want to go. Now, if you change directions, then you'll end up doing sort of this hobble instead. So you just gotta stop and then just... Alright, enough of that. Let's see, is this the way? Which way do I want to go? Okay, so I do want to go this way. Sammy man, does whatever Sammy can. Not afraid of anything, unless your name is Ridley. Is there another Asborian in here? Oh no. You can shoot stuff, okay. I was just thinking, where else those things in particular that comes to mind? And I was like, well, that creature also shoots things at you. And then that thing launched something at me. Like, oh, okay, so you do shoot stuff. Probably just go ahead and, once I find the first save. Oh, speaking of which, then I'll end the episode. Because otherwise this one's gonna be pretty long. Anyway. Thank you all so much for watching. As always, God bless, and I hope to see you all next time. Ciao!